What's up, guys? It's your boy, Spide Productions here. Today, we are here with the next episode to Miss Marvel. This is season one, episode 5, Time and Again. So last episode was actually a pretty cool action-packed episode. We, Kamala and her mom went to visit her grandmother to get more of their family history about her bangle and get to learn more about her being a djinn and everything. And we also got the djinn was able to escape the Department of Damage Control's prison and was able to escape and go after Kamala. Kamala met up with these like secret organization of people that I guess were tasked to stop the djinn before their plan is to turn our world into their world, basically. They want our universes to merge, but their universe to take over ours. So that's a thing. And in order to do that, they need the bangle so they can bring more of their people over. So, and then I believe at the end of the episode, we were in a fight with Kamala and her, and the lady, I forgot what her name was, but we got into a fight with Kamala and her, and it sent Kamala into like another vision, but this time she's stuck there in the past. So I guess we're going to learn a bit more about her great grandmother's history and learn more about, I guess, where this bangle come from, why she has it, what she's had to deal with since she's been on Earth, all this other stuff. So, without further ado, we're gonna jump right into this and check this out. It was a cool action scene. Oh wow, that's cool. They made it old fashioned looking. That's awesome. Whoa. Struggle of independence. British occupied India, 1942. Oh, that's a great grandmother. Damn! She's pretty. Okay. She's really pretty. Wow. His leg is already broken. Is this Kamala's great-grandfather? Is that who that's supposed to be? Obviously. Okay, so I'm assuming that's Kamala's great-grandfather. Oh, fuck. I thought she was gonna try to kill her. I like how she's like, oh, I hit the banker for safekeeping. Oh, well, you have until tomorrow to get it. So she never told him about her heritage? Not telling him anything that happened. Oh. Oh, damn. She just killed her like that? Wait, so is Kamala the one that saved her grandmother? Because if that's the case, then that means she time traveled. If that's what we're doing here. So her bangle caused her to time travel? So wait, you saved your grandmother. So is this time travel? Is that is what this is? She time traveled, and that's how this story happened? She just wakes up as evil. Oh, what is that? Oh no. Yeah, we're not chipping a human being, bro. Jesus. Nah. Close it. Oh, damn. What is that?
It's a portal, but it's not the portal to take them home. Clearly not.
This girl's gonna walk into it and die. Oh, really? What is she doing? Damn. Wait. What? Oh, he has powers too? He has powers too? What the hell is happening? hard to explain. Okay, so here's my question. Okay, so I have a question. So if the girl is not the villain, so if she's not the villain, is the guy going to be the villain in this? The Karmen? Is he going to be evil? Because now he has powers similar to Kamala's? Or, yeah, who's, because she's not the villain. I mean, she is, but she just died. That's cool. He's a dope dude, I like him. Oh, it looks like her star outfit. Or her thing, her lightning bolt. Really? Bruce Springfield, what? That's funny. I mean, honestly, you need proof, because that's kind of some crazy stuff to just say is real. Dude, can you say his name right? Jesus Christ. You're just insulting at this point. Bruno. No.
Jesus. No, calling Brian. Dude, your mom just died to give you powers.
Mother effer. What the? What? That's a weird way to end. Are you serious? That's a weird place to end that. Like in the middle of an action scene.
Let me see if there's any post-credit scene. Because I believe this is like one of the, this is like the last episode before the last episode. Okay, there's no post-credit scene. Fine.
That's just weird. Alright, that's a weird ending. Other than that, it was a good episode, actually. I really enjoyed that. It was just the ending was strange. But, yeah, man. So now we got backstory on Kamala's great-grandmother. And we know where she's from, how she met Kamala's great-grandfather. And we know how all this story started. And now we know that Kamala's actually the one that saved her grandmother and got her back to her dad. So, did Kamala technically time travel? Is that how we're explaining that? Like, this, the reason that the story was a story was because she time traveled back in time and helped her grandmother get there? Interesting. Okay. Well, I actually genuinely enjoyed that episode. I thought it was pretty decent. I thought it was pretty good. It's usually the calm before the storm type of episodes. This one was more of a backstory, so that's why I enjoyed it much more. Obviously, Marvel has been doing some of the calm before the storm episodes in the MCU so far. Like, they did in Moon Knight, Falcon and Winter Soldier. I believe they did in WandaVision for a bit. But yeah, it is just the backstory of everything. But yeah, I genuinely enjoyed this. It was really good. Alright. Well, there you have it, guys. That is my reaction to Miss Marvel Season 1, Episode 5, Time and Again. I hope you guys enjoyed my reaction to this episode. If you guys did, let me know in the comments down below what your favorite part of this episode was, or your favorite part of the series so far is. Curious to know what your guys' thoughts and opinions are in the description down below. Drop a like on the video for your boy. Hit the subscribe button to be part of the community. Hit bell notifications so you guys know when I shall post next. And I'll see you guys next time. Peace.